So, kung ano ka, may asawa ka, and then hanap ka ng iba, it is the most, pleases, the one that pleases Satan the most. Yan po. So, you consecrated your life to Satan. Witchcraft, according to the well-known exorcist Monsignor Melivoke Lubanik, in his book An Exorcist Speaks, how to recognize and protect oneself against the snares of the devil. There are those who abandon themselves to Satan, who then becomes their master. These people make the pact with Satan by willingly and completely surrendering to him. So meron talaga ganito. So naka-experience din tayo, but we will focus on the experience of Father Sikiya, mga kapatid. Meron din nag-surrender natin na isang satanista, mga kapatid. So meron silang pact, willingly and completely surrendering to him. Conscious sila na ang pinapak nila, yung demonyo talaga. The back is made up in a form of an imitation of the rite of baptism. May sacrament of initiation pala sila. Which this sign with their own blood. Totoo talaga ito. Yan, kino-confirm ito sa isang satanista na nag-surrender sa atin. In the name of Satan. As a consequence, people fall under the complete and direct influence of Satan, their master. They perform black magic rituals in his name and become members of satanic sects, which sadly are growing in number. He describes the abominable rite called the Black Mass, where the culmination of the Black Mass certainly occurs during communion, in which the stolen consecrated hosts are mixed with the blood of the sacrificed animal that the participants are to drink. Totoo ito. Kino-confirm po ito sa... So, ito yung observation and experience sa isang known exorcist, si Monsignor Malivoke. And then, si Monsignor Malivoke, isang known exorcist, no? Sa kanyang aklat, The Exorcist Speaks, mga kapatid. So magkakatay talaga sila ng kambing, and then yung dugo ng kambing ihalo sa dugo nila. It is a blood compact, mga kapatid. And then magnakaw sila ng consecrated host, no? Magsagawa sila desecration sa sacred host. And then sa mga lay ministers ngayon, sa mga pari, mag-ingat po tayo sa mga nagsamba para lang manakaw yung consecrated host. So ito, makikita mo bakit hindi atatakihin ng mga satanista yung ibang sekta. Di ba? Usually, Catholic lang talaga ang atakihin nila. Why? Because the Catholic Church is the genuine and the real church founded by Jesus. This satanic act coincides with sexual orgies that are expected to procure magical strength. So kasali din nila yung sexual intercourse, no, group sex, no. At kino-confirm ito sa isa sa mga nag-surrender sa atin na satanista, mga kapatid. Grabe. The satanists maintain that this type of sacrifice is the one that pleases Satan the most. Sexual intercourse, no, group sex. Grabe. So itong gawain nito, the one that pleases Satan the most, no? So kung ano ka, may asawa ka, and then hanap ka ng iba, it is the most, no? Pleases, the one that pleases Satan the most. Yan po. So you consecrated your life to Satan. So during this secretive sciences, they offer animals, humans, and even children at the altar, sacrifices to appease the evil one, no? Yung bata, no? I-offer nila. Grabe. para lalakas yung magical strength nila. Yung magical power nila. Victim, a 27-year-old woman named BC. So, itatago lang natin sa pangalan na BC. Was a 27-year-old woman from one of the provinces in the north. When she was still in elementary school, she was sexually abused by two of her cousins. So, biktima sila. Sexually. Growing up, she was not emotionally close to any of her parents. They were absentee parents due to work and other worldly commitments. And when she related the abuse to them, her parents did not believe her. She has three siblings. Although she was intelligent, she was not appreciated within the family circle. So, yan ang nangyari mga kapatid. Dahil sa kabisihan ng mga nanay at tatay natin, absentee pa yung iba, walang panahon sa mga bata. And then, lack of appreciation. Ito po yung family background po ni BC. Si BC had an unhappy childhood. Walang magandang experience sa kanyang pagkabata. Puro negative lang. The family unit had that should be a protection to a child growing up in the world was absent. So, ito talaga yung pagkabuo ng ating pamilya. Yan ang the greatest protection sa mga bata. Kung atak na yung pamilya mo, it is not a greatest protection. You put them to peril, mga kapatid. So, mag-isip tayo, lalo-lalo yung mga tatay na pinabayaan na yung mga anak. Lalo yung mga tatay na pinabayaan yung mga asawa nila. Lalo yung mga ina na pinabayaan yung pamilya nila. So, mag-isip-isip kayo. No? We see here why one of the devil's most used strategies is to destroy the family. The family unit that should be a protection to a child growing up in the world was absent. We see here why one of the devil's most used strategies is to destroy the family. Yan talaga. Sadly, later in life, BC also experienced being continually raped by friends. Grabe, no? Group sex, group rape, no? Grabe yung trauma ng batang ito. Alam ko nagbabasa kayo, grabe, no? Nabibigyan to ako sa traumatic experience ng bata. Of the family. She, at that point, started to isolate herself and became withdrawn. So, hindi na siya. Isolated na yung buhay niya sa mga tao. She had a number of abortions. Oh, grabe. Multiple abortions. During this time of sexual abuse, kung nabuntis siya, iblalagdag niya. Her relationships began to rapidly deteriorate and she continually had fights with all those around her. So, grabe. Wala nang kapayapaan yung isip niya. Her only refuge was her barkada. Wala naman yung pamilya niya. They had become the center of her life, yung mga friends niya. And she reached a more mature age. She finally ran away from home and became a working student. Her entire life was school, work, and party. So, party, party! Let's enjoy life to the max. No, she was later discovered by a satanic cult who knew about her past traumatic experiences. They knew how to lure her into their group through her many wounds in life. So doon papasok yung mga demonyo sa mga wounded experience natin, traumatic experience natin, problematic na situation natin. She eventually joined this cult in order to get revenge against those who had sexually abused her. So, bakit pumasok siya? Para makaganti tayo sa mga taong nagsagawa ng injustice sa iyo. As well as to gain power that she could use to fulfill her ambitions and plans in life. Pati na yung mga plano niya. And to become a full-fledged member of the cult, she had to be initiated with satanic rituals. So, na-discoverhan siya na asset natin ito. She had to be initiated with satanic rituals. She was not alone. There were a few others who would join her in the initiation. So, nandito na yan sa Bohol, ha? Yung satanista mga kapatid, nandito na sa Bohol. May pasyente tayo na member sa satanism. So, mga magulang na nakikinig sa akin ngayon, please take care to your children po. No. Kumustahin niyo po yung mga bata ninyo. During the initiation, which was almost 2 weeks in duration, 2 weeks ha, yung initiation nila, and it started on a Friday, she would go frequently into altered states of consciousness, hypnotic states, or hypnotic trance. It seems that a lot of hallucinogenic drugs were used to bring this about. Parang nag-take siya ng drugs, no? So, ito po. Ito na po yung case of possession ni BC. During this time of the initiation, she would always feel tired, dizzy, and confused. So, parang naka-vertigo. She would always feel tired. Ang pagod. She was also used frequently as a sexual object by the male members of the cult when she was in this trance state. Kung papasukan na siya ng maraming demonyo, mga kapatid, no, ay gagamitin siya sa mga lalaki, no. One of the ritual of the satanic group, sexual intercourse. At one point in the initiation, all the recruits were wearing black robes completely with hoods, were required to share all the negative experiences in their lives. So, mag-sharing din sila, may BEC din sila. ang sharing nila ay, yung mga negative, mga wounded experiences, mga traumatic experiences, anong pakay nila doon? Sabi dito sa aklat, the more negative and painful, the better. The reason of this sharing was to bring about a hardening of each one's heart in order to block or permanently any positive emotions. So, para maging matigas na yung konsensya mo. Maging dead na yung conscience mo. A dead conscience. They shared and intensified all the anger and hatred in their hearts and learned to release in them, no, parang binabalik-balik nila yung mga negative experience. They were moreover taught how to black out and cut off anything, feelings, experiences, and anyone, family and friends that was good in their lives. So, black them, no, yung mga tao na magandang intentions, black them, yung mga sorry father, anong na-send man to na, hindi ko nabasa kapatid. In witchcraft and satanism, hatred in the heart is especially needed when casting diabolical curses and hexes, as well as giving the devil a stronger power over the person. Basta, grabe yung hatred mo, hindi ka na matablan. Yan, no, malaking ano yan, excuse mo na, malaking lalaki yung kapangyarihan ng demonyo sa bakit hindi nag-charge ito? Excuse mo na mga kapatid, ha? Bakit hindi na-charge ito? Malapit malubat yung ating yulu light. Okay, patuloy tayo mga kapatid. Grabe, no? The next step in the initiation process was the giving of occult infested objects, bibigyan ka ng amulet or talisman or anting-anting, and training each of the recruits on how to use them against those who have hurt them and anyone else they deem as an enemy. So pwede magagamit 'yon sa mga kaaway mo para makaganti tayo. Yan. These objects were therefore to be used in a black magic. At one point in the initiation ritual, each of the ritual recruits was forced to engage in cannibalism. So kakain sila ng laman, no, ng tao. There is no need to go into details regarding this unimaginable aspect of the satanic initiation process. Yung, hindi, mag-aalay sila ng tao, di ba? Mag-aalay sila ng bata na aborted. And then kakain nila. It is cannibalism. Grabe. Near the end of the initiation rites, all of the recruits were required to make a pact to Satan through a blood offering, and each of them had a sign with their own blood, a written pact with the devil. Yung nag-surrender sa atin, may blood compact, no, may sugat siya dito. No, it is the blood compact with Satan. Inahalo daw yung dugo niya sa dugo ng kambing, and then they are consecrated to Satan. Meron ba siyang satanic name, mga kapatid? Okay? Then they were swore allegiance to the cult until death. So, kailangan ng allegiance, ha? Faithfulness to Satan. They also swore that any children that they would bear would be offered to Satan. Lahat ng mga anak nila should be offered to Satan. They furthermore swore to recruit new members regularly to the cult. So, hihikayatan din sila na mag-recruit sa mga bagong member. So, grabe yung demonyo, no? Overtime na sila ngayon. Patuloy tayo, mga kapatid. After the initiation ritual, which was done in one of the highest mountains in the Ilocos region, Bisay started to see clearly the demons surrounding her and her companions. Nakikita na niya literal yung mga demonyo. She not only saw them but could also hear their voices and was therefore able to communicate directly with them. So makausap na niya yung demonyo. Grabe. No, sinusurrender niya. Conscious ng conscious. Full consent yung ginagawa ni BC. During the next months, BC was taught higher levels of black magic. Itinuturoan na siya higher level of black magic. How to curse. Make potion. Totoo, may potion na lumay o gayuma. Totoo yun. How to conjure many spirits. How to do astral projection. Pag-travel, kahit nandyan ka lang sa isang lugar. Maka-travel ka sa iba't ibang lugar. To harass her enemies. How to harass her enemies. And how to attain certain preternatural powers over her body. So, grabe yung higher dimension. So, ito po. Maganda po ito dahil sa huling banda nito, paano ito natulungan sa mga kasamahan natin na nauna sa atin ng mga exorcists. It's Father Francisco Jose Siquia, Father Fernandez Kabading, no? Pero salamat muna tayo, mga kapatid, sa mga star senders natin. Uy, salamat ng una si Sister Marilu Pea, no? Nagpadala sa atin ng 2,000, sa live natin ngayon, 2,010 stars. At pangalawa, si Sister Sheila Bito, 300 stars. Salamat, sister. Si Mercy Alferez, 300 stars. Salamat sa mga generous na star senders natin, mga kapatid. Si Ami Dacuba na Elga, nagpadala sa atin ng 100 stars. Salamat, kapatid. Si Rinan Matelia Azur, nagpadala sa atin ng 100 stars. Si Mercy Turquatur, no? 100 stars, no? Mga star, regular star senders natin na hindi mawawala every time mag-live tayo. Si Eden Mirantes Clemente, 100 stars. Si Glizel, 50 stars. Si Chena Guevara, 50 stars. Si Ray Ibora Gamayon, 10 stars. Si Lynn Tapao, 10 stars. Salamat po. Rian Norin Hernandez Salin Nana, 10 stars. Si Pia Che, 10 stars din. So, salamat po. At ipatuloy tayo, mga kapatid. Ang ganda nito. No? So, makausap na yung demonyo, and then tinuturoan na siya for the higher level of black magic, mga kapatid. So, pwede na niya mag-course yung mga nasa paligid niya using the ritual, satanic ritual. Makaganti na siya. No? So, yung ano yung makadrive nila, bakit pumasok sila dito? Para makaganti. Yan ang dory ng evil spirit sa mga tao na gustong gaganti. There was a time in Biz's life when she had to live in a boarding house in order to to be closer at to her work. This house was run by religious sisters while living there. So, parang malapit siya sa trabaho niya, lumipat siya sa mga sa may boarding house, and then napunta siya sa mga religious sisters, sa dormitory ng mga religious teacher sisters. While living there, the sisters had a very hard time with her. She was very unstable and combative, and therefore always a cause of fights among the boarders. So siya lang magdadala ng mga kaguluhan sa dormitory. So naguguluhan niya yung mga madre. But the sisters did not want to give up on her, asking her to leave. Sinabihan niya na leave the dormitory sa mga madre. They tried to help her as much as they could, but to no avail. Kahit tinutulungan na siya sa mga madre, pero hindi siya mag-cooperate eh. Dahil naharas talaga siya ng demonyo. Well, at then nag-cooperate din siya sa consecration ng demonyo sa kanya. While BC was living in the boarding house, right before and during a full moon, the desire to harm others would become so strong. So kapag full moon, lalakas yung kapangyarihan ni BC, yung mga curses niya ay maging mabisa talaga. Another thing was that when she would see human blood, kung makakita siya na may masugatan, nakita niya yung sugat and then may dugo, she would experience a strong urge to drink it. Ang sarap. Inumin yung dugo. In the boarding house, BC was also seen to possess certain incredible preternatural powers, like she could blind and she could climb any kind of tree easily. Grabe. Extraordinary na, di ba? She would be seen as though she were floating up the tree. Oh, parang lumulutang na sa ibabaw ng kahoy. And could remain perched on even very small branches. So, pa sa mga maliit na mga branch. Now, BC, while holding a normal job, continued to attend regularly black masses. With her cold and sexual urges were frequently during these occasions. Grabe. Patuloy pa siya ng black mass, no, grabe yung ginagawa nila doon, no, group sex, and then desecration of the consecrated rose. Grabe talaga ito. The cult held these black masses to push subdivisions in many cities. Ano ang intention sa black masses? At post subdivision in major cities and including Manila, they would hold their diabolical rituals near parish churches and religious convents in order to send curses and hexes to the residents. They all especially enjoy targeting contemplative convents by conjuring and sending the most powerful fallen angels there. In my experience, these curses are usually death curses that cause sicknesses and infirmity, as well as hexes that cause discord in the community, emotional mood swings of anger, sadness, depression, and fear, and finally sloth and dryness in one's spiritual life. These curses can also cause preternatural attacks like bangungot, or what we may call night terrors, and other more physical types of demonic oppression. The demons usually give more power to their followers, who are able to cause the most damage of the church. For instance, when a religious leaves his vocation due to the curses sent, however, if their followers fail, the demons usually inflict some form of painful punishment on them, which is quite easy for the evil spirits to do, since the Satanist is physically and spiritually open, therefore vulnerable to them. So, yan mga kapatid, yung black masses pala, isa yon sa mga paraan na ma-curse nila yung nearest parish, nearest convent, nearest na mga religious congregation. Anong intention nila? To curse. Para masira yung kumbento, para masira yung simbahan, and then lalabas, kung lalabas yung isang religious, no? the followers, the demons usually give more power to their followers, who are able to cause the most damage. May reward sila galing sa demonyo. So, mag-ingat po tayo. So, kailangan natin ng catechism talaga sa buong Katoliko, sa buong Pilipinas, hindi lang sa buong Pilipinas, sa buong mundo po. It's about time to catechize the people of God. Catholics should therefore always be on guard and protected with the proper sacramentals. So, yan ang kinakailangan natin. These weapons have always been used by the greatest saints of the church. Salamat po. Si subscriber Crystal, no, nagpadala sa atin 2,500. Siya na nanguna ngayon sa mga star senders natin. Okay, pangalawa si Sister Marilupia, 2010. Si Eden Didi, no, 1,000. Salamat sa inyo po. Salamat po. Hindi, patuloy tayo. Mga kapatid. Some Catholics perceive the sacramentals as merely for show or for display, while others think of them as outmoded and old-fashioned. These are dangerous sentiments, mga kapatid. Other targets of the followers of Satan are government officials and leaders of civil society in order to cause moral disorder, havoc, breakdown in a social and moral order. Demons give clear instructions to their followers since... Ate! Ano, Bishop? Sige. Mga kapatid, itutuloy lang natin ito. Nandito na si Bishop. Fight Team Maria, tatak si FD with a humble heart.